My drone crashed.
So, my drone just crashed for, as far as I can tell, no reason. I was really high up and not near anything.
So, what the hell happened? I don't know. I'm as confused as you are, so let's take a look at the video and try to understand maybe what caused the drone to fall out of the sky. After sending the drone into DJI, they sent it back and they said there was two reasons why it crashed. The first is that it didn't have GPS. We know that's not why it crashed, we'll get into that later. The second is that inexperienced pilot led to crash. Let's analyze these two things separately and try to figure out if they hold water. So the first, not having GPS, we can know this is not true for a few reasons. The first is that the drone was hundreds of meters up in the air. DJI drones have a flight ceiling of 10 meters when they don't have GPS, so it's just impossible to be that high above the takeoff point. It doesn't matter how high you're above the ground, but above the takeoff point, you just can't do it unless you have GPS. The second way we know it's not true is that the drone was reporting 14 satellites, so it was connected to 14 satellite GPS. And the third and kind of obvious way we know that it can't be true is that the drone was reporting GPS, and this is actually how we found it. It reported the GPS signal up until the moment it hit the ground, and that is why it decided to hike up the river an extra hour there and back, an hour to retrieve a drone. If it wasn't in the river, we wouldn't have even bothered trying because there'd be no possible way to get it in that valley.
So, my drone just crashed for, as far as I can tell, no reason. I was really high up and not near anything, but we still have a 900 meter climb to go home, and it's getting late, but I'm gonna try to get it anyway.
This was a huge risk for us because whether we found the drone or not, and it was very likely that we weren't going to, it would make our wetsuits wet. And we had 900 meters of climb that day, and we'd have to carry an extra 2 or 3 kg in just water by having wet wetsuit. It was a huge deal to go get it. It wasn't a simple thing to retrieve the drone, and we were only able to do it because of the GPS signal from the drone. So we can dismiss the first one as just not true. Should also point out that whether or not it had GPS is also totally irrelevant, because even without GPS, it still shouldn't cause propellers to pop off in mid-flight. But I think I know why they're saying that. So remember I talked about that flight ceiling can only go up 10 meters. So when I took off the drone, I took off from a location without GPS, which is very common for being in a canyon. So take off without GPS, just fly out over the river to a wider part. It's a more open area, and the drone can get the GPS signal, and after it locks the GPS signal, only then will it allow you to fly higher. So it's a very normal situation. It's a very common thing to do for people who fly out in the canyons here. I'm sure many of my viewers have been in that situation. Regardless of having takeoff GPS or not, it definitely had GPS when it was flying so far away and so high. The hardware just doesn't allow it to operate otherwise. As for the second part, inexperienced pilot, well, I take a little bit of offense to that. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if I'm an inexperienced pilot or not, because even if you're an inexperienced pilot, you still have to crash into something, right? This was hundreds of meters up, hundreds of meters away from anything. There was just simply nothing to crash into. So regardless of your experience level, unless you crash the drone into something, it should still not fall out of the sky. That's just simple, basic logic. A little offensive that DJI would even include that in the report. To me, it seems like they did not even watch the video because it had GPS, and because inexperienced pilot only matters if you crash into something. To me, they just didn't look at the video. My assumption is that they saw that the takeoff had no GPS, took off without a return to home point, and just immediately assumed the rest and just said skip, okay, standard response A and B, go on to the next one. This bothers me for a few reasons. Our DJI drones, are they falling out of the sky so often that there is no time? You guys are so busy and unable to review these on a case-by-case basis? Like, what's going on here? Are they just falling out of the sky left and right? Why is it that there's no time to review my case? And two, before reviewing the case, they insisted on not just all of the flight data, all of the flight records from every single flight ever flown on the drone, but also every single video that was ever taken with the drone. This is a huge problem. This is an invasion of privacy. If videos were taken for clients, I, you know, might not even be able to show them the video because of contractual obligations. But the biggest thing is my privacy. This is a really offensive thing to do. At first I said, you know, no, why do you need, you know, every flight ever taken? I give you the flight of the crash and the flights from that day. Why do you need more? And the response was, we will not review the case. You do not qualify for the warranty protection unless you give every single video ever flown on the drone. So I didn't have a choice. Fortunately, it was a brand new drone, so I only had to send in 2 months of videos. Other people, if they had to send in a year of videos, I don't know how that would work, but it's a huge invasion of privacy, and in my opinion, a just really terrible thing to do to insist that we have to open up our life and show people everything we filmed on our camera, even things that are unrelated to the incident, before they review the case. So I was not happy about that at all. But I did it. And despite doing all of this stuff, it was still returned with this sort of nonsense response. So at least I feel a little bit better that even though I did send in these videos, at least nobody bothered to pry into my privacy because it looks like they never watched them. But this raises the question, what really did happen? So we tried to review a few possible things. We hiked up them, we checked the area, we confirmed that there's no pipes, there's no wires, there's nothing that the drone could hit. You know, we even entertained these crazy ideas, like what if a monkey threw a rock or something like that? No, impossible, it was hundreds of meters away, that it's just not physically possible for that to happen. The first thing we entertained is could it have been a bird strike? This time of the day, around, 10 a.m., there's not really big birds flying in the sky because of the way the updrafts were, so we didn't see any, but we considered it a possibility and looked for evidence of that. When I got back, I also researched online. I looked at as many possible bird strike crashes I could find. In all of these cases, the drone had some movement from the impact of the bird. So it would go sideways or back. That's what I looked for in my video. So we put the video into Premiere, go through it frame by frame. And what we can find is that the drone starts falling immediately. If you look at this image, this is the first frame where the drone starts to fall. In this image, at the bottom 20% of the screen, we can see that there is a blurry part. This is something called rolling shutter. It shows that the camera is moving down and to the right, and then in the next frame, we can see it's already spinning very fast and falling downward. If we continue to go through the footage frame by frame, what we can see is also that there is a propeller missing. The drone was spinning so fast that the gimbal whipped around and it focused right on the arm, and it shows that a propeller is missing. It's not there, it's not broken, it didn't hit something and break, it's just gone. That starts to make a lot more sense when we look at the motion of the drone and what's going on. So because this happened so fast, it happened in about a 500th of a second, and there was no shaking or judder at all, it makes me think that there was no impact involved, that the propeller just popped off on its own and the drone immediately started to fall and spin because there were still three rotating propellers and of course not one on the arm that's missing it. What could have caused that to happen? I showed this video to several drone experts and friends before getting a response from DJI, and we quickly debunked several of the possible causes. One, for example, would be if the propeller was put on incorrectly. This is a Mavic 2 Pro propeller, and it has a locking direction. So for this one, it locks this way. You have to push it down and lock it. Now, this locking motion, this is counter to the motion of the motor. So if we turn it this way to lock it, the motor is going the opposite direction. And that means that as this turns, it's actually getting tighter in there, not looser. If it was not in place, it was just sitting on top, as this turned, then it wouldn't lift the drone. Instead, when it turned fast enough to generate lift, spins up, the drone doesn't move anywhere, and the propeller flies away, and then you're stuck with a drone on the ground with no propellers. There's absolutely no way the drone could fly up, go for 10 minutes already, and then this come disconnected due to a improper installation. It's just not something that can happen. You can see this very clearly in this video by Hey Drones. It won't fly with an improper propeller installation. And while I don't recommend you do this yourself, they then proceeded to crash it into trees a bunch of times and even threw a backpack at it. It's a very interesting video. I'll put the link in the description below. Even if it were to strike something, it wouldn't come disconnected. It's possible that it would break. I've seen lots of videos where they've crashed into things and did not break. There are no pieces in here. There's no evidence to suggest anything here that the thing broke. I don't consider that a likely explanation. Also, you can see that when the drone fell, the other three propellers were still on the drone, including the one on the arm that actually hit the ground, traveling 57 kilometers an hour, and snapped in half. Even that one, the propeller did not come off and did not break. They're actually quite flexible. It's not easy to break one. It would be very unheard of for one to just sort of explode from hitting something. It's just not the way it works. There are connection points here which would fail, and you'd end up with a piece of plastic sitting on the motor that isn't a propeller, just a piece of it. That's not what happened. We have a clean motor, nothing in it. So, we've established that what happened is that this propeller came off. We can see that very clearly from the video. The question is, how did that happen? We can see it didn't happen from an improper installation because it had already been flying. We also know it didn't come out from hitting something because that's not the way the levers work, and that if it did break, it wouldn't completely come out. It would be broken. So, what could have happened? The only thing I can think of is that the inside here, there is a mechanism due to either a quality control issue or a design issue. The springs that are locking this in place gave way and this flew away. So you can see it's not even easy for me to get it off. It's a complicated thing. So this flew away. I think this is the most likely explanation. So that's where I'm at. And I hope that people who are watching this, maybe you can try to give me some explanation. DJI, I want to say directly to you, I'm very disappointed with your response, mainly because it appears that you didn't even look at the video and just gave me some sort of a standardized response that doesn't apply to my situation. I'm also a little annoyed that instead of covering this under warranty, you offered to fix it for 24,000 NT, which is really insulting. I don't know what's going on, or you know, maybe you're just too rich to care about the customers anymore, but I did not appreciate that. This is never about the money. I have the DJI Care, which I bought when I purchased the drone, and I replaced this drone for 3600 NT through that process. I didn't want to do that. The reason that I bought the insurance is so that when I'm in a canyon or some other kind of tricky to fly situation, I don't have to say to myself, okay, is it worth the risk to get the shot? I can say, you know what, I'm insured, I'm gonna get the shot and we're gonna make an amazing video. And if there is an accident, it's okay because I'm insured. I definitely did not buy the insurance so that these quality control and design problems could be paid for by me instead of you. This drone, all in with the extra batteries and the goggles, cost me 80,000 NT. That is a huge purchase for me. That is one of the most expensive things I've ever bought. As a filmmaker, when I go out and spend 80,000 NT, I have a lot of options for what to buy. Maybe I should have purchased a really nice long telephoto zoom lens instead. It could have given me also another edge to my filmmaking, and it wouldn't fall out of the sky and would probably be covered under warranty. It's just mind-boggling to me how little you can care about a customer. Even if there is a separate explanation for what happened to my drone, and you know, you guys have all the data, you have all the tools, you've seen everything that happens, you could at least have said that instead of this generic, didn't even bother to look at it response. It's very insulting. And as somebody who uses your products commercially, it's very disturbing. I no longer trust this drone. I'm very concerned about flying it anywhere. I'm worried it will just fall out of the sky. I only have one replacement on the insurance, so if it happens again after that, I'm basically screwed. I am very worried it'll maybe fall on somebody or a car because it's just falling out of the sky for no reason. Because I was not given any explanation for why it crashed, I have no information that I can use to prevent it from happening in the future. As such, I really cannot recommend anybody get a DJI drone at this time. As many of you know, I started a Facebook group that was really specifically to retrieve lost drones. As we can see, drones are falling out of the sky left and right, and some of the people who lost their drones, some of them are saying like, yeah, it just stopped responding. It wouldn't return, or you know, it just fell out of the sky. I don't know why. You know, it seems like I'm not the only person who has had this issue. And when you just search online for drone falls out of the sky, you see quite a lot of cases. And the standard response seems to be that these people aren't believed. You know, their drone just malfunctioned and, you know, had a catastrophic failure, and they aren't believed. There seems to be a lot of criticism of these people, like, oh yeah, whatever, you did something stupid and now you're trying to, you know, get something out of it. I think that these people should probably be given the benefit of the doubt, because here I am in the same situation, confused, with a drone I don't trust, I have no idea why it fails, no explanation from DJI, no cover of the warranty, even though just 2 months old, 80,000 NT. Yeah. Why, DJI? That's all I got. Please let me know what's going on in the comments. I'd really like to hear, especially your experiences with this situation, or if you have any other type of explanation that you can give me about why it would have fallen out of the sky from hundreds of meters up. Anyway, if you like this video, please consider subscribing. I am trying to shift everything over to YouTube right now. My drone videos might not be that great coming up because I don't trust my drone, but we'll try to give you lots of other content. While you're at it, leave a comment. Let me know what you think of this video. You know, am I wrong? Is DJI wrong? Let me know in the comments. And please click the like button. Those likes help me out a lot. The button looks like this if you're not sure. You can see my other drone videos in Taiwan. You can see the scooter road trip that we took it on, or we can see a collection of drone videos here. It's really such a beautiful place here, and it's been an honor to be able to fly around Taiwan and capture these videos, even when my equipment fails. So.